Hello, everybody. Lost Connection here, back in an episode of Song of Styx. We are in and out of struggling between population problems. Slowly getting up the human nursery together. We're almost there, and then we'll have a mass amount of population growth. It'll be 40 for every 4 years, we'll get a massive wave of humans. They're going to be very demanding. Once that has happened and I get the bathhouse up and running, I will then try to get a military together. Ah, is that how long each race takes in a university? So, humans take the longest to educate, but I think are the best for edumacation stuff. The pigmen are the quickest to educate, but I think are not the best. Yeah, they have not the best in admin, technology, emissaries, but they're good as a laborer. They're also easy to immigrate. Oh, is this the what they're good at? Like, legitimately? So they have really high skill levels. Oh, absolutely in the gutter, that job. So yeah, they make poor crafters. The elves make okay crafters, and the humans are the best at, well, they're also okay. Like the Dundorians, because they're like dwarves in their aspect, are, yeah, they're all good at the crafting. I think this race is amazing at crafting and other work like that. What is this, the spider race, good at? Absolutely nothing. Like, they work as guards. That's like the bugmen. The bugmen are also kind of just laborers. So the Agargosh hate the elves, but the elves don't really hate the Agargosh. The spider people. So I do have technically one thing that I would like, which is meat. And I could get fish into my economy as well as a backup source of protein. So, they actually can work a decent amount of jobs, they just can't be a crafter or a farmer, or even work in the fishery. But they're really good fighters. So I might actually want to start encouraging a... Then how would I get this race? People can keep getting mauled out here, so might as well make a fence so people stop wandering into the wild animals.
Thank you.
at this massive good graveyard. I think we have a massive stockpile of food, plus the cattle don't care about droughts.
Thank you.
Yeah, and everyone immediately started living here than probably where they were living originally. Oh, I love how it's just slightly quicker to go grab it from the other market. I'm assuming the scientists are slowly getting replaced from the pigmen to humans inside of the laboratory. That's why I'm slowly going up. They are better at research than anyone else. Before I invent pit fighting, I probably should invent something else. Should probably invent hospitals before I invent pit fighting. Because, you know, people are probably going to get injured in a pit fight.
Thank you.
I'll actually take that, because I do need the cut stone. It almost scared them into extinction by putting that fence around them. As long as they stay in that pen, no one's gonna die. And the numbers should eventually recover. Ah, so this is a buffer. So it eventually the grave will be reused. We're gonna wall these guys in because they keep exploding outwards. I don't want someone to get accidentally mauled. That's what I'm doing with all these wild populations. I'm essentially giving them their own little preserves. I'll never like build into, because if it's ever we need an emergency source of food, we can tap into the preserves. One thing is, in the attempt to preserve this species of animal, I almost killed it outright. I did make them into a very small box, so it's understandable why they almost outright died. But that'll be it for this episode of Songs of Styx. If you enjoyed it, please like, comment, subscribe, and peace!